are surprised by, are penalized by the internet censorship, and most of the Chinese people are against internet censorship in China. But I don't know where you get that, but as far as I know, according to a survey done by Chinese Academy of Social Science, found that 80% of Chinese people are supported government control of internet in China. And I also want to remind you that our motion today is internet censorship should be banned. It means in any part of the world, if you, from your perspective, any part of the world, internet censorship should be banned. But I don't know why you only focus on China. And the figure just, you just showed for some, a lot of people to visit the site in Twitter for the Japan beautiful actress. Those figures compared with 1.3 billion Chinese people is really, really small. That improves that the internet censorship of China really works rather than fail. So also you mentioned about the freedom of speech. I think you only take part of that definition. The freedom of speech is a speech refers to that are not morally harmful and not dangerous and not offensive. If you want to enjoy your freedom, you cannot violate others. It's illegal. So I think you may not completely understand the freedom of speech. Also, you mentioned that the internet censorship will do harm to the country's democracy, especially for China. I want to mention that Britain is a well-known country for its democracy, but Britain has an internet censorship system called Clean Sea. I want to explain why that many democracy countries in China, in all over the world, they have the internet censorship. And it must be a reason or several reasons something to exist, just like what the second speaker or you said, have just said. Now I want to share with all of you why the internet censorship should be banned. For it should not be banned. For internet censorship is beneficial to social stability and social security, which are very, very important for a single country. Firstly, the government of multicultural countries are sensitive to this religious and racial views, and government would rather censor the internet than take the risk to a hate speech that may lead to social riot and social disorder. Take the former government, for example. Burma is a country with so many rebel affiliations. The government fears that the country may face with disintegration, so they take a very strict internet censorship to prevent any potential social disorder happen. Secondly, the terrorism is spreading in a very fast speed on the internet without censorship. This alone may lead to catastrophic outcome. Who would take the responsibility? Who can afford to the responsibility of damage that's caused by the terrorism? According to a research done by United States Institution of Peace, the scan of the internet from 2004 and 2003 reveals that there are hundreds of internet websites that are serving the terrorism, and they serve them for multiple purposes, from brainwashing, education, and recruiting, fundraising, and most importantly, the plan of attack. But if this detrimental information are exposed to our innocent citizens, what will happen? Please bear in mind that with the mass media, the internet today is very influential in mobilizing people into action. So that should the government take the risk of thousands of lives towards someone's urge to express oneself to the self-expression, the answer is certainly not. So, I want to restate that for the sake of social security and stability, the internet censorship should not be banned. It should be improved rather than banned. Thank you.
Debate is coming to the end. So let's welcome the fourth